told by our special teacher. Well, I'm not well versed in Bengali, that's why I would like to deliver in English. I think you won't have any problem, isn't it? Because the course you are going to pursue, that is in English, you have to study in English, you have to just attend the lectures in English, and you have to write in English, so everything is English, that's why you have to be well versed in English, so you should not be afraid of English. Rather, you have to enter for 5 years, not 5 years, till your break, till your life, okay? So that's why, you know, you have to try your level best. You should not think that, you know, I'm not well versed in English, so how can I cope up with the situation? How can I just go through all the books in English? Gradually, if you have that passion that I have to learn something, if you have that passion, if you have that that kind of willpower, obviously you will just, you know, come across all those situations. You can just, you know, cope up with the situation, and you can just, you know, wade through this hurdle, isn't it? So, as I used to tell, and my teacher also used to tell, that for the moment I am your teacher and you are my student, so I am also a student. So everybody should think that, you know, I am a student, but with the only difference that you are a junior student and I am a senior student. Because, you know, we have to keep on learning from cradle to grave. We have to keep on learning. So there is no time that where you have to think that, you know, I have learned everything, I don't think anything. No. You have to keep on learning till your last breath. That's why you have to keep on thinking that I am a student, isn't it? So this way, that's why now we have to know, because this is the orientation class. Orientation class means you have to be well acquainted with the course you are going through. This is the course of 5 years, 5 years integrated course. It means after these 5 years you will become law graduate. And we have heard, you know, from the students that everybody is thinking that after this course, everybody will go for practice or litigation. No, this is not. This is the minimum graduation course. After this, it doesn't mean you have to go to the court. No, you can pursue some other things. You can become UPSC officer. You can become IAS officer. You can go for bank services. There are so many opportunities. This is the minimum criteria, which is graduation. After graduation, whatever the exams are there, maybe bank exam, maybe, you know, IAS exam, maybe, you know, West Bengal Civil Service exam. Whatever the examinations are there, which are available for all the bachelor's degree holders, so you can go for that. And other than that, those are exclusively for you people, means the law graduate, judicial magistrate, you can become judicial magistrate, you can opt for the West Bengal or any other services, you can become law officer, you can become corporate law officer, you can go for legal process outsourcing. There are so many opportunities exclusively for the graduate, law graduate. And, you know, generally, whatever the course available, I mean, you know, jobs are available for all the graduates, you can opt for both. So now you have to find, you have to decide that, you know, what exactly you want to pursue. I'm going to tell you that, you know, lots of the people have, you know, fantasy. Fantasy means if you see a lawyer, for example, Ram Jaipurani, maybe Harish Salve, Mukul Rohatgi, you know, have you heard about these lawyers? Harish Salve, Mukul Rohatgi? No. Have you heard? These are the stalwarts in the legal field. If you see that they have been taking 20 lakhs per hearing. How much? 20 lakhs per hearing. And some take more than that. If you see that, you know, he has been taking 20 lakhs per hearing. And I want to become like this. If you see this only, if you are dreaming like this, it is what? This is only fantasy. So only fantasy, you know, will not become, make you so. What will make you so? The hard work, the dedication, the work with perseverance. If you work like him, then only you can become like him. You are deciding that I want to become him. It means you have to see the hurdles, you have to see the hardships. Whatever he has gone through, after those hardships, you can achieve something in life. So whatever you pursue, whatever you want to achieve, you have to have a goal in mind, that is, I want to pursue this, I want to achieve this. After setting this goal, you have to keep on working hard, you have to work hard on that, and ultimately we are here to help you out, we will help you out, we will encourage you. And if you keep on doing this, if you have this willpower, and if you just do this with that kind of hard work, ultimately success is yours. Somebody told, I am just telling you, that, you know, you are not failure till the moment you have just left trying. If you keep on trying, it means you are not failing. Once, twice, thrice. One of my friends, he kept on trying for 7 years when he joined BLB college in 2002 with me. So at that point of time when he was asked, what do you want to become? He told that I want to become a judicial magistrate. And he was a mediocre student. Everyone was laughing at him. That people like you, How did he become judicial magistrate? But this was his passion. He passed in 2007, B.A.M.U. honors. After that, he kept on trying for 7 long years. And ultimately, in 2014, he got selected in UP Judicial Services. Ultimately, whatever he aspired for, 14 years back, because 12 years back, 5 years for law, and after that he just prepared for 7 years. It means 7 plus 5, 12 years. After 12 years, his dream came true. It means he kept on trying for 12 long years. That's why if you want to achieve something, then you have to keep on trying, you have to have this willpower, and you have to have that hard work. And I think with these words, I would like to conclude my thanks.